Yeah, Smart War Games here. Let's check out a grand strategy game by HOD. You can find it on Matrix Literine or on Steam, Wars of Napoleon. It is following the base formula of most of those HOD games, at least before Empires. So if you played one of those, you should be becoming familiar with this one quite fast. Yeah, the content. There's some interesting options you might want to see. Modifying the game. And probably offering a new experience. Yeah, the game is sometimes, but it is basically true for all HOD games, that loading times in between turns might be long depending on your campaign progress. That is also something that is often broke up for Rise of Troisen. And yeah, I myself didn't experience it too bad. Perhaps this has something to do if you run a SSD, or but normally it is not tied to the hard drive but to other things. I also heard from others that they run a tool called, I also sometimes used it, but I don't know if it was really placebo or it helped. But it seems like in this Prusia game it helped indeed. Many guys, I think I tried it out and it helped. What is it called? There's a tool in order to modify your performance profiles. This in the base version 3. So whatever, if you have any issues, check it out. If I remember the name of the tool, or if somebody knows what I'm talking about, post it in the commentary. So yeah, scenarios. You have 6 scenarios. 2 scenarios are basically like grand campaigns. There's one starting in August and one starting in January. The biggest campaign comes with 527 turns, so this is an epic experience. You can play the 2 major nations, France and Britain. However, you can also play Spain, Austria, Russia, Ottomans and Preußen. So all major players are here, which participate in the war. There's also some limited action, like the Austerlitz campaign, so more on an operational level. We might check out one of those, or I simply play a couple of rounds of the grand strategy, grand campaign. But it is hard to show you the flow of the game in a grand campaign. But perhaps there's a full playthrough by somebody else on YouTube. I will give you an overview of the game. So, yeah, let's check out the main campaign, the grand campaign. Yeah, as mentioned, the interface is basically what you know from all those HOD games before they switched engine with Empires. I think it is pretty good. Yeah, it comes with tooltips. That is for me most important. I think the map looks quite good. And yeah, you sometimes read Steam reviews. It's not, the interface looks old school and whatever. I think it's functional. Yeah, it's, and once you, like with John Tiller games or whatever, once you know one game, you will know the other games. I never had somehow a struggle where I wanted to do some input and was thinking, God damn it, this game annoys me. So yeah, about the interface, let's see, what can I, yeah, first we might activate a layer in order to show you the politics currently. Yeah, you can activate here the layers like you might know from Paradox games. That is the map. Yeah, zoomed out. One thing that is perhaps always is a bit, but that is that the game, depending for example on zoom level, might sometimes struggle with fluidity. That is true for all HOD games. Some regions are represented like on a board game by zones. Yeah, so In order to make the map smaller, a lot of regions will be simply represented by those zones where you can move on. There's some colonies and whatever which are, were also forked by the coalition versus France. Which I think is an elegant solution. Yeah, that is also how board games do it, and why not on PC games? Otherwise, you would have to expand the map to global size, while most of those regions wouldn't be really relevant for the war. It's quite a huge map, and yeah, we talked yesterday about Napoleonic games. There are not that many depicting it on grand strategy. Serious ones. Yeah, I know Total War and Napoleon, but I don't consider that to be real. That is more a bit more action and casual. This might be a good choice. Okay, yeah, you have also other layers which you can use. Like in most of the grand strategy games, weather, etc. And no overlay. If you like to play in politics mode, the great thing is you still see the terrain, but you might not see the weather, but often by hovering over, you see, for example, in this pop-up, the weather, so you can quickly check what the weather is. You don't need the visual information on that. Yeah, units come with real portraits. Seems to be very nice. I like the art style. It is timeless, classic, not some 3D crap. Like in modern Total War games, for example, something like Rome Total War, where everybody's looking like coming from a clone army. And yeah, you can activate details by pressing this small thing here, or by pressing here, you can activate unit details. It doesn't matter if you press here or here. What I notice is that they don't have pop-up text. They are not filled out. You see here this middle text. I guess this means the file is missing. Perhaps there's a mod around I didn't check out. If there are mods for this game, which might add the text. I also noticed it for the generals. Yeah, we figured in other HOD games it was always a nice detail that you could educate yourself on those generals. For example, I'm not an expert on Napoleonic era, but the text files are missing. Could be added. You see there's a string which might look for a file, but they are not in the game, it seems. And other than that, yeah, you can organize your units in armies and then attach corps to it. Business as usual. Empire management. Yeah, you can set units with postures and give them some basic orders what to do when they encounter enemies or specific situations. Can give special orders like splitting, promoting leaders, divisional command, etc. Yeah, recruitment mode where you can recruit units from green areas, naval units, batteries, infantry brigades, which you then can use to fill your units. Let's see, we have some decisions here available. Could, for example, pay. Ten development points, 10 loyalty, £50,000. We have £18,000. So it's basically 50. That's not too much. Developer area. Let's see, what do we want to develop here? Brandenburg. Yeah, and that's it. Brandenburg is now developed a bit more. Could invest more. Even Brandenburg is very... Here, for example, I guess what is that? There's a lot of... But military. Horse breeding. Yeah, and you can check other decisions. It's basically like cards, yeah. It's like cards which you can play. They cost you or come with often with some downsides. Yeah, for example, martial law. It costs you development points. And but you can and gain quickly loyalty in an area. Or drafting quickly units. But might cost you victory points. Plunder an area, but it will cost you the loyalty of this area, etc. A lot of cards to be played. That is the amount of cards you can play. So always great, and you can also filter those cards. Always good to check out decision mode. Then a strategic atlas that is basically an overview over your units where you can also quickly see what is going on where. A lot of Garnisonen, yeah. And some cores. Lisa also included, okay. Good, that is forces. Wait, that is, let's see production. Currently, we are producing nothing, we might do that. Currently, we have no reforms available, no decrees, but this might become available. Yeah, history of nations. Nothing happened because we didn't play on a single turn. We might initiate some diplomacy, perhaps with United Kingdom, see what they have to say. Oh, Great Britain, I mean, United Kingdom. Yeah, but that is not really required. Strategic map overview. You can quickly see units. Quick overview over the regions. Yeah, your scores and objectives. There's our objective list and who is holding it currently. Köln is currently occupied by the French and also have the entire region has French loyalty. And we have currently neutral relationships with them. Because we started the big campaign, I think it starts with a peace, with a longer peace phase, while the other grand campaign starts basically, I guess, if you want to go right to war. Yeah, you can play also this game by PBM, like, or Hot Seat, I think as well, like the other HOD games. And there's some campaign introduction. Good, let's draft some troops in our area. See what we can draft here. Coastal batteries, fortress, that is, I guess, stationary. Siege arty. But I guess infantry. We have four in force pool, let's draft those guys. Ah, okay. What are we missing? We are missing conscripts, okay. Currently, we don't have enough conscripts to draft them. We could draft some ships, but let's save it up and see what happens. Ja, das Game ist turn-based. And maybe Mike move something to the front lines, but currently it is peacetime, yeah. I guess the spa is for every nation. Some battles happening between the French and okay, so the war is already starting. Yeah, okay, turn, I mean, as I mentioned, yeah, of course it requires some time. Calculate, but this is a huge map with millions of territories and units moving around. Yeah, about moving units around, I mean, I think this engine is quite straightforward, yeah, by drag and dropping those unit cards. Yeah, they will duplicate, you will see basically where they are and where they will go and what time they require to reach there. I can also modify it at waypoints. Or remove those waypoints. I think that was always a quite good system. I mean, you need to also to, if you see those reviews, there's a lot of people trying to play those games coming from Total War, expecting Total War, only looking for graphics. Always take those Steam reviews with a grain of salt, some people buying games without even knowing what they buy and then leaving a bad review. This interface is not perfect in every sense, but I always think it is quite straightforward, and once you figured out how to do it, it is pretty good. And better than many other games, which where you need to struggle around. I like this drag and drop mechanic, for example, and that you can design waypoints, remove them. Ah, okay. So if I there, you remove basically. I get it, okay. Sometimes struggle to stop movement. Yeah. I always do it by simply moving the real unit flag, putting it. Oh no, okay. That is a grand scenario, but if that is too big for you, you can also play some smaller. Perhaps we can play some smaller to show you the warfare. That's also what I did in those other ones. Let's play Austerlitz. I mean, it still plays on a huge map, but it seems like a limited action. Probably most other countries, yeah, not activated in this scenario. Good, where's Napoleon? Yeah. Singen in Straßburg. Okay. We have pontoon bridges, which is great, which means we might pass this river here. Do I need to activate them somehow? Guess it will simply give us the bonus. One day, it's not too bad. Yeah, join Mordred and those guys are not under my control, okay. We have some scout calf in front of us. Let's rejoin them. Perhaps we join those guys, our army as well. I mean, they are some sort of flank protection. On the other hand, not. Wait. Oops, stick to that. And calf, yeah, perhaps it's not a bad idea. Check out forward while we move our army. To this region. And Marcena move here. But that is forest. Let's move here. And do Shem, do Hashem. Follow him. Oh, this unit is locked, okay. Okay, Recruitment Mode is deactivated for this scenario. So no recruitment. I need to set the scav to evade. Forgot that. You scout ahead with formations in front of your army, you should set them to something like evasion. Otherwise they might engage decisively and get destroyed. Yep, Austrians inbound. Well, this army is stronger. I might watch out here. Might need to form up for a battle. But this will probably overburden our army. This army is already running on maximum almost maximum command. Yeah, that's not my units, it is Barbarian units, yeah. Missed the color difference. Yeah, find out what is going on there. Tell me information. He's a spy. And Napoleon advance. Ulm might be our target. Yeah, come on, let's engage and we'll show you combat. Good, let's see if those units are set properly. We will go... In case we attacked, we will go with our offensive posture. Nothing too major. A sustained attack here, yeah, that is with some aggression before they can form up. You see, I cannot perform offensive actions this turn, okay. Okay, Bylot declared neutrality. Good. Yeah, I mean, engage him immediately. Well, let's go a bit aggressive here. That is here not some professional playthrough, but showing you a bit. Just because there are two armies nearby doesn't mean that they will indeed engage each other immediately and kill each other. this sense this game is a bit more realistic than many other games where battles are decided and then it's over. First off, both armies need to find each other, then both armies need to agree to fight each other. There's also the way in this HOD game that two armies can coexist in a region, because both armies are probably not interested in attacking. If both are running defensive postures and trying to evade combat or whatever, which is something you don't see often in those other games. And in many other games, they clash together and then magically battle happens and everybody is killed. Some games do it a bit better, where only organization is basically removed, less manpower, like in HOI or EU-based games. Okay, that okay, unit retreated from battle here. But there was no recommit. What can indeed be sometimes romantic is if you need to stuff a lot of armies into a small region, and yeah, good night. Perhaps there's a way without merging them, because otherwise you might overtax them with command. Okay, what is going on here? Good, we have relationship system, then continue and cut off into Augsburg. Ah, okay, you need to move through this area anyways, because we can't enter Württemberg. We can, but it seems to be very slow, because it is forest and no roads, nothing. Yeah, let's hit Ulm. And try to engage this army that is sitting in the city, I guess. I think this button needs to be activated for sieges, right? Yeah, one thing I didn't show you is the manual. You can do that. It is 160 pages, so it is some to read, but again, there's also some, at least a couple of tutorials in the game. It seems to be well made from a visual aspect, at least. Yeah, there's a battle screen in case we don't, but we should soon see a battle. Well, you can see what goes into the calculation of them. Currently try to engage here Fürst von Schwarzenberg. Which I guess is sitting behind the walls of Ulm. I'm gonna check south. Oh, it's pushing the Treviso. What is also about this game a bit which I like, others might say it is a problem. No, I think from a reality standpoint it isn't. I mean, you can synchronize movement, but it's rather difficult to synchronize movement between different elements. So you can't simply create a huge stack because you will go over the command rating or the command allowance of those. So you need to maintain several formations and then make them arrive at the battlefield or whatever. You might one element is defeated before the other one arrives, but that is reality. That is, if you read about those historical accounts, that is exactly what happened on a daily basis in this war, yeah? That elements engaged each other while another element was still a couple of days away. It was not just only about quantity of units, it was also about coordination, and sometimes you simply had to wait. Yeah, I mean, the music I hear in the background, very... Can we make it? This recruitment. Whatever, not that important. Or not 20. Great. Yeah, use the bridge. Exactly. You try to form up with those guys. And the rest continue pushing into southern Austria. What the heck? The fastest way. Yeah, there's a river crossing. What is with this bridge here? No, don't like it. So he's using some heavy arty or whatever that is. Good, that is... That is army command, that is flank droid. And a couple of cores. Yeah, main army march forward. And yeah, I don't know, left flank, do we want to apply them to the north? Flank Gouche. I mean, then we might get separated. Could also keep them simply on flank protection and focus on hitting those areas. But there's a lot of capture. I mean, sooner or later we might need to split this army. Let's do it. This will also put pressure on the Austrians. Entschuldigung, what the heck, was? Was hatten die hier, hey? Yeah. Ja, ist die aus HOD Games, complicated. It is confirmed. Okay. Yeah, in case if you need to bring a lot of elements into a small stack, it's simply throw it somewhere on the center, but not on the other unit, otherwise you might order them to merge up, which might cause issues. Like exceeding command limits. Okay, what is going on here? Yeah, this guy is a hostile army. Go offensive. Okay, not possible. You can also drag them on the enemy card, yeah, like I did here, and then you can usually get a lot of units into a small space. There's also a way to make it visually a bit more easier to tell, but it is fine, yeah, you will handle it. The real guys had even more serious problems there, so don't cry around. Okay, yeah, won't do it again. Bad luck. Save often. That is general for HOD games, save often. And I don't know, those system settings, default, this game is set to use memory 10%. I know that memory limitation often can lead to crashing. I don't know why they set it to this. Perhaps to make sure that it runs on toasters. Okay, finally we have a battle, that's what I wanted to show you. Yeah, because you have some decisions to make, that is always great. Let's say we want... high reserve deployment, yeah, then we can... And use a counterattack plan. Yeah, I like that, yeah, that is something I would like to see in other games. That's why I wanted to show you this. I mean, you can have the middle solution. Either you have games where you need to control every single guy, like in Total War or whatever, which often leads to a gamey experience because you can... A, it is often not true to real commanding. B, it is... often you can then out-cheese the AI. Then you have games where you have absolutely no impact. Yeah, you simply like EU or whatever, you simply run two stacks into each other and then the numbers begin to crunch. And after a couple of in-game seconds, everything is over. While I often would like to see more games as a middle solution, yeah, where you are basically the commander, but you have a lot of decisions to make, but on a real command level, not on a hive mind level where you can command every single unit in real time. Something like this, and perhaps with some in-battle decisions. Yeah, where's the detail? Normally... There's a detail screen. Ah, here. It was faster than over... Okay, yeah, the battle is over. Yeah, this little button here is detail report. And then you can see what happened, what modifiers, Archduke Karl versus Marshal André Massena. We lost 21,000. They lost 8,000, lost us a lot of Cav and Arty. And then you can see what bonuses were here applied. That was the first day of the battle. The first day was not really good for us because we deployed Marcena quite. But it happens. The next day might look different when our reserves arrive. Or the rest of the army arrives. That is the Main, I think that was the main. Yeah, I can't look it right now. Massena was leading the army, right? He's not in lead of the other elements. And what I really like is the amount of information. You know, every bonus is displayed here. Sure, you could argue that in a huge battle, those individual bonuses go haywire, and not really that important. But who knows? Yeah, nobody can tell. Or that those tactics, how much they do. I mean, they use basically the same tactics that we do. Copycats. But I still like it, yeah, that you have some... More would be even better. But that's what I wanted to show you, because I like the idea. That's not often mentioned, I think. Now it is Bernadotte versus... plus... some... plus friends... versus Karl Mack von Leiberich and homies. Johann von Wisch, Franz von Werneck, and Michael von Kienmeier. His homies are joining him here in a battle that looks rather in our favor. So this time, infantry mass deployment, but we also need to use our arty. Let's try arty. No, not counter battery, grand battery. Give me a grand battery. But our arty is not even that much stronger. Yeah, but our infantry is also not that much stronger. Okay, yeah, the first day was a victory. But a Pyrrhic, or not really something to write home about. Both lost a lot of casualties. The good news is that we took out 10% of the arty of the enemy. And then the battle will continue. Yeah, those units are not wasted. You can't simply... I mean, there is battles where a short amount of time entire armies stopped existing. It true happened in history. But you often have those sustained engagements where you can bring up reinforcements, and which was quite interesting. Okay, yeah, this should give you an overview of the game. Make sure to save often. I don't know this memory slider, why it is put on zero. If it is better to have high memory, I mean, from what I've learned so far, by experience, it's often better to allow a game for more memory than less memory. Especially if you have a lot of memory. And I'm pretty sure this game won't stress out my amount of gig. Perhaps I can imagine on smaller systems, or on weaker systems which have, I don't know, toaster, 1 GB RAM, or whatever, then you might need to put this memory setting on low, because otherwise the memory might overflow. But usually what I've nowadays see more to be a problem with games is that you often have those classic games being memory limited. Yeah, you might heard this 2 GB limit or 1 GB limit. Some games might be unlocked with this tool. Then usually you do stuff, memory is filling up of the game, and then you want to do something and the game doesn't have enough to allocate, and then usually crashes without saying anything. It's those typical memory crashes. And I would rather say give the game more memory. But test it out for yourself. Not sure why they put the lever on 10% physical memory. I mean, 10% might be already quite, in my case, a lot. For a game like this, which isn't coming with very much visual stuff to process. But yeah, check it out. And save often, even in turn. So there might be a hotkey or whatever. Because it is true, those HOD games, they might have sometimes like crashing. Yeah, that is also, I've also seen it. And they're great games, but don't play, I don't know, 10 hours without saving and feel safe. Always safe. Get a save routine. Okay, we might check out another one, which is considered to be one of the best of the HOD series and one of the best of American Civil War. It is HOD's American Civil War 2, which is for many ACW fans one of the best games of this era. So I'm back in a couple of minutes and then we will check this out.